Welcome. I'm Lyndon Chubin, Director of Education and Public Programs at the Morgan. And in 2021, we are celebrating our 15-year partnership with Young Concert Artists. We are delighted to bring this series to you virtually until you can join us again in Gilder Lehrman Hall. I'd like to thank Dan Kellogg, President of YCA, the staff, and talented musicians who are performing for us. We also could not present these concerts without the generous support of our funders. It's my pleasure to introduce Dan Kellogg and enjoy the concert.
I'm Daniel Kellogg, President of Young Concert Artists. We're so grateful to Lyndon Chubin and the Morgan Library and Museum for co-presenting this encore series. Each of the artists in our series were presented at a New York debut last season, and it's a special pleasure to bring you their performances this year. Today, we welcome cellist Jonathan Swensen and pianist Adam Golka in a program featuring the great Debussy and Rachmaninoff cello sonatas. We're so grateful for our sponsors, Paul Secri and Mark Goody. Thank you. We hope you join us for our next concert at the Morgan on April 7th, featuring violinist Randall Gooseby and pianist Zhu Wang, featuring the music of Ravel and Brahms. Thank you again to all of our sponsors and supporters. We hope you'll visit our website, www.yca.org, to learn more about our artists. Please enjoy the program.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jonathan Swensen. I'm 24 years old and originally born in Copenhagen, but also from the States through my father. Today, we're going to present to you a program which I dearly love, and Adam does as well. A program of great variety. The first piece we will play for you is the Debussy Sonata, which for me is one of the most, you could call it, hip sonatas, I think, because it is something, some kind of music that has never been heard really before and never been heard since then either. Debussy, with this sonata, he manages to look back to his predecessors in the time of music and look forward and revolutionize, find new ways of playing, find new techniques, new tools. And at the same time, the work is so complete and compact in its 12 to 13 minutes, which is the length of the piece. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. The next piece we're going to play for you is going to be the LUTOSŁAWSKI Grave, which is a very special piece for me. A piece that slowly builds up from the bottom of the C string with deep sonorous sounds, slowly getting more and more fast, hectic, and building up towards an absolute cry, a real scream, almost so painful that it isn't even human, and ends in total abyss. It feels like the ending to me is like reaching for the stars. It feels like it's something that's bigger than all of us, in a very quiet way. I hope you enjoy that piece. It's very special to me.
Thank you.
And the last piece we're going to play is Rachmaninoff Cello Sonata, which is just an amazing sonata. I'm sure many of you know of it, and those of you who don't, you're really in for a treat. It's a real journey of life, you could almost call it, ending in the most optimistic fashion and beginning in a very dark place. I guess that could be related to the fact that Rachmaninoff had been extremely depressed until meeting a psychotherapist who helped him greatly and served him so much help and inspiration that he wrote this cello sonata and the second piano concerto, which are two of the greatest works by Rachmaninoff, just absolute inspiration. So we start very dark, and then the second movement is stormy and wild, and we get to the third movement, which is the heart of the movement, very tender, melancholic, looking back upon the pain, but with a new sense of love and light, maybe, towards it, a sympathy towards the past. And ending in a total ecstasy with the fourth movement, which is just an absolute declaration of happiness and enthusiasm. I hope you enjoy it, and I'm very happy to play for you today. Have a nice day.
Thank you.